Nobody asked me, is there any requirements to be in the American Indian Movement? And I've been kind of kicking it around in my brain, and after hearing that song, I now know the requirement. You need to be arrested. I have a couple of daughters in the audience. Tanya, are you here? Is Arrow? Arrow's over there. So, I want to point that out. Also, grandkids I've had up here, and they were actually here before I got here. And finally, they almost said, Dad, you gotta come to Standing Rock. So in July, then I made my first appearance over here. But I want to say that I just got back from Japan, a 20-day tour, and the big news in Japan is the two things. One of them is about the election, the other one is about Standing Rock. You know, should even be in the news.
Right.
When you got Standing Rock, when you got an assault that's going on against civilian population by military troops, our troops, the sheriff's supposed to be protecting and serving our people. But we know from the past 500 years what kind of treatment that is. It looks to me like they are practicing war. War on the water protectors. The people that protect the air. People that protect the soil. People of Mother Earth. We are those protectors, and history is going to show that those police, the rubber bullets, the shrapnel, the concussion grenades that tore off the... I saw those pictures of this young lady, and those people are practicing war on us. They are practicing war. And I want to say to those on the front lines that I'm honored just to be in the same territory that you are right now. Never in my history of 80 years have I seen such courage as, like, you know, I mean, you're talking about wounded knees here, but the courage of those water protectors rises high above. They say, we don't fight with bullets. We fight with the determination of our beliefs and responsibilities as water protectors. That will always be our answer.